Hey guys, this is Jump, jumponline.ph, and today we got here the latest charger from Ugreen, the Ugreen GaN Fast Charger. It's the 100 watts variant. It comes with four ports. Later on, we're gonna talk about this one. But yeah, this is the best solution for those people who are looking for a single charger for all of your devices, whether that's a laptop, a tablet, or your brand new smartphone, probably an iPhone since the smartphone doesn't come with a charger anymore. Anyway, there's a lot of things that we need to talk about this one, but before we get down to that, time to unbox and time to take a closer look at this newest charger from Ugreen. Alright, so we got here the GaN Fast Charger. As you can see in here, 4-port fast charging, smart protection, a foldable plug, and wide compatibility. And yeah, we got here the different USB-C outputs. We got here the USB-C 1 and C2 at up to 100 watts max. The USB-C 3 at 22.5 watts max. And of course, the USB Type-A at 22.5 watts max. So you really need to choose the best port for you. I mean, if you're charging a laptop, it's better that you plug it in on the USB-C 1 or the USB-C 2 output. But if you're charging a smartphone that doesn't go more than 22.5 watts output, well, you can use the USB-C 3 or even the USB Type A. But of course, if you're charging four devices at once simultaneously, you can only have up to 100 watts. You cannot have a 100 watts on the USB-C one, another one at 22.5 watts at the USB-C 3, and of course, another 22.5 watts at the USB Type-A. All in all, it should be equivalent to 100 watts. All right, time to unbox this one. All right, so we got here the Ugreen charger. There we go. It comes with a lot of weight. Actually, it's still very portable. It's not that light compared to what you're seeing right now. It does come with a weight. But yeah, it's a 100 watts charger, so I'm pretty happy with it. So as you can see in here, we got here the USB-C 1, the USB-C 2, the C3, and of course the USB Type A port. We also got here the manual along with the specifications. I've mentioned this one earlier. So we got the USB-C 1 or the USB-C 2 output with up to 100 watts max. Then the C3 at 22.5 and another Type A with a 22.5 watts max. And of course, we need a total output power of 100 watts max. You can't do more than that. It isn't just enough for the GaN Fast Charger. As for the charger, as you can see here, this one is made up of plastic. Ugreen logo over here. We got here the foldable plug, very portable, three USB-C ports, and of course the Ugreen logo over here. Nothing much to see aside from these ports. Now time to check out these ports, if they are working really nice, if they can really output up to 100 watts. So for our laptop, we're gonna use the green cable and we're gonna plug it in on the USB-C one as this one can output up to 100 watts. For our smartwatch, we're gonna use the USB Type A for that one. And for our Xiaomi 11T Pro, we're gonna use the USB C2. And lastly, for the tablet, we're gonna use the USB C3. So hopefully we can get near 100 watts with the Ugreen charger as long as we charge all of these devices simultaneously. So first, we're gonna use the Huawei Watch 3 and let's see if we can charge it. So there we go, it's now charging at 1 watts only since it's a smartwatch. Next is the tablet, and as you can see right now, we're charging it at 9 watts only. Next is the Xiaomi 11T Pro. And lastly, our laptop. So right now, we're charging the laptop at up to 33 watts, the Mi 11T Pro at 7 watts, then the tablet at 9 watts, and of course, the Huawei Watch at 4 watts. Basically, that is around 32 plus 7, that's 39, plus 9, that's 48, plus 4, that is 52 watts already, and we still got a lot more power that we still have in the Ugreen charger. But of course, we want to maximize it. We want to reach up to 100 watts. So give me a few seconds as I will just change the devices that we got right now. So we've changed our devices. We've now plugged in two notebooks. One is an MSI laptop. The other one is the Realme Book. And we got here the Mi 11T Pro. And of course, we got here the Watch 3. So as you can see in here, we got 26 watts, plus 34 watts. That is already 60 watts. And then we also got here the 7 watts, 67 plus 4. That is 41 watts already. That is really amazing, all right? For a really small package, for a really small charger like the Ugreen GaN charger. So for our next setup, we got here the ROG Flow. We're running it at 41 watts. We also got here the 11T Pro from Xiaomi at 21 watts. So that's already 62 watts. We also got here the tablet from the Apple iPad Pro at 10 watts. So that is already 72 watts. And we also got here our smartwatch at 5 watts. So all in all, we got here the 62 plus 10, that's 72 plus 5, that is already 77 watts. So if you are traveling, I'm pretty sure that you would love the Ugreen charger as it can charge all of your devices with only a single charger. So if you're looking for a charger for all of your devices, you want to have a single charger solution for all of your devices, well, we got here the Ugreen 100 watts charger. It's a pretty good charger. We got two USB-C ports that supports up to 100 watts. That is pretty good if you have a MacBook Pro or an iPhone or whatever device that you have right now. If you got a MacBook and iPad, you can use the two USB-C ports. And then, of course, we got here the USB-C, another one for the iPhone, and the USB-A for your Apple Watch or your AirPods or whatever device that is. But overall, this is a great single solution for all your charging needs, as this one can reach up to 100 watts. And I believe a lot of people wouldn't need more than 100 watts. Most consumers would be happy with the 100 watts. I mean, it can charge your MacBook, your iPad, your iPhone, and your Apple Watch simultaneously and without problem. So yeah, I guess that's it for our short review of the GaN charger, the 100 watts GaN charger from Ugreen. So if you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and be sure to click that subscribe button along with that bell button to get notified of our latest videos here in my YouTube channel. So once again, I'm John from JohnOnline.ph. Thank you for watching and see you guys again in my next video.